Welcome to our channel. Today I am briefing you another Indian literature poem from Mirabai, Binding My Ankles with Silver. Mirabai and Bhakti both become a Sidhana. Her ardent love and devotion towards Lord Krishna is also well known. Mirabai was born in Rajput family in the town Meratha, Nagaur in Rajasthan. She was married in an engaged age by her parents with a neighboring king. After her marriage also, she continued to worship with Lord Krishna. Even her husband supported her. But soon she became a widow. But she refused to be a sati. Hindu religion practiced sati, where women should sacrifice their life during the death of her husband. But Mirabai refused to do a sati, to be a sati. Then she later left her home to be with her Lord Krishna. But her brother-in-law and mother-in-law were not accept her way of life, so they tried to kill her. She left home to be with her Lord Krishna. Mirabai was a Hindu mystic poet in a Bhakti movement. She was referred to a Lord Krishna where she saw her husband, lover, master. Mirabai's poem was in a simple form called bhajan, a term used for a small spiritual song which is composed in a simple rhythmic form with a repeating refrain. The salient characteristics of her poem is a complete surrender. Her longing for union with Krishna is predominant in her poetry. These are all some points about Mirabai and her life. I will brief you about the poem Binding My Ankles with Silver. Firstly, I will read full poem and then I will explain line by line. Binding my ankles with silver, I danced. People in town called me crazy. She will ruin the clan, said my mother-in-law. And the prince had a cup of venom delivered. I laughed as I drank it. Can't they see? Body and mind aren't something to lose. The dark ones already seized them. Mira's lord can lift mountains. Binding my ankles with silver means wearing bell on her feet that is made up of silver. I danced. People in town called me crazy. She started to dance and sing in the street after the death of her husband. So people thought she become a mad. So she is doing like this. So her mother-in-law, she will ruin the clan, said my mother-in-law. Means mother-in-law is telling that she is spoiling their reputation by dancing in the street or singing in the street. But she was fully devotion towards Lord Krishna. And the prince had a cup of venom delivered. Prince means her brother-in-law, where he gave her poison in her food. I laughed as I drank it. She knows he has given poison to her because of her life, what she was doing in the society, like singing or dancing in the street. Can't they see? Body and mind aren't something to lose. She is questioning them. There is nothing from the body or mind to lose something. She has already lost everything. Like she has, her husband has died in a young age. So she is completely submerged towards Lord Krishna. The dark ones already sees them. The dark ones means here they are telling about the color of Krishna. His personality is dark. So he is punishing them. So she is telling the dark ones already sees them. Mira's lord can lift mountain means when Vrindavan people were cursed by Indra, like 7 days, 7 nights, whole Govardhan hill was lifted by Krishna and protected for Vrindavan people. Finally, Indra gave up and asked sorry to Lord Krishna and prays to Lord Krishna and left. So this is meant by this: Mira's Lord can lift mountains. He is her refuge. Means Mira is telling that Lord Krishna will protect her from everything. Like he will give shelter, food, and also protect from the enemies. So finally we see how Mirabai was so devotion towards Lord Krishna. Even though her family, like mother-in-law and brother-in-law, who gave her. So finally, in the conclusion, I wanted to tell that how Mirabai has gone through struggle throughout her life. So this poem has portrayed her life cycle, how she has gone through struggle. Even she has refused to be a sati. That is very important point we have to note down. Like long before she has refused to be a sati, that has practiced. Sati system was practiced in Hindu religion. That we can see in this poem, how she has opposed or refused to be a sati. And then another point we can note down in this poem is how devoted towards Lord Krishna Mirabai was. Whatever has happened in her life, that Lord Krishna has seen her. And also we can see the last line: he is her refuge. Means she tells that he was the person who gives her shelter, and also she see her him as her husband, lover, and master. By this, I will end my poem. Thank you for watching my video. Please like and subscribe to our channel for more educational videos.